Hello friends, welcome. In this video tutorial, we are going to implement Hibernate second level cache using Spring Boot, JPA, and PHCache. So what is Hibernate second level cache? Hibernate second level cache is created in the Session Factory scope and is available to the whole application. It is not enabled by default. We have to use third-party cache providers like EHKSA, OSKSA, and SwarmKSA. In order to use Hibernate second level cache, we have to define a cache concurrency strategy. So there are four cache concurrency strategy: read-only, read-write, non-stack read-write, and transactional. Use read-only cache concurrency strategy when you are sure that your data never changes. If you try to update the data using this strategy, Hibernate will throw an exception. Use read-write strategy when you do lots of updates on your entity. It provides strong data consistency when multiple transactions try to access the same object. So when multiple transactions try to access the same object, the transaction which accesses the object first acquires a log, causing the other transaction to read data directly from the database until the log is released. Non-stack read-write strategy is similar to read-write strategy, but it does not provide strong data consistency, as there is no lock mechanism. So when multiple transactions try to access the same object, there are chances that you may get stale data. So use this strategy when stale data for a small time window is not a concern. Transaction strategy is suitable on a JT environment. Any changes in the cached entity will be committed or rolled back in the same transaction. So in order to demonstrate how Hibernate second level cache works, we will create a Spring Boot application which will be consist of two REST APIs. The one will be a POST API which will simply save the city in the database, and the other will be a GET API which will simply fetch the city for a given ID. We will be using Hibernate second level cache, and then using the GET API we will verify whether our data of city is getting fetched from database or cache. So now let's get started and create our Hibernate second level cache project using Spring Initializer. So I have opened up the start.spring.io to generate our Spring Boot application. So here in the group section, I will say com.dev.tokens. In the artifact, I will put Hibernate second level cache. Okay, the description is fine. Now let's add the dependencies for our project. So our project requires Spring Web. JPA. And for our application, we will also use H2 database. Okay, so we have added all our needed dependencies. Now let's click on the generate button to generate our Spring Boot project. So our Spring Boot project has been generated. Now let's copy this zip file and I will put it inside my V drive YT project folder. You can place this zip file anywhere you want. I am placing it inside the YT project folder inside my D drive. Now let's extract the zip file. Now we will open this Spring Boot project in the IntelliJ. So we have opened this project in the IntelliJ, and the dependencies are getting resolved. So our project is ready now. The first thing that we need to do in order to use Hibernate Second Level Cache is to add the dependency for the ES cache. So I have opened the pom.xml file, and in this pom.xml file, I will add the dependency for the Hibernate ES cache. And the thing to notice here is that the version that I have provided here is 5.4.12.final, and this version should match with the Hibernate version that you are using. So in order to know which version of Hibernate you are using, just click on the Maven tab on the right hand side and just expand the Spring Boot data.jpa dependency, and inside this you will find out that the Hibernate version which we are using is 5.4.12.final, which matches with our Hibernate ES cache dependency. So now let's open our application.properties file and provide the configuration for our Spring Boot application. And we will have these properties for our Spring Boot application. If you want, you can just pause the video and write down these properties manually. And I will also provide the Git repository link from where you can just copy the properties into your properties file. So the first property here is used to enable the Hibernate second level cache. The second property is used to provide the factory class for the ES cache. And the third property is used to set the mode. We have set the mode to enable selective, which means we have to explicitly tell that on which entity objects we want to enable Hibernate second level cache. So by default, cache will not be enabled on all entity objects. We have to explicitly tell that on these particular entities we have to enable Hibernate second level cache. The next set of properties, we have set the configuration for our database. So we have provided the data source.url, driver for the database, username, password, and database platform. We have set the Hibernate DDL-auto property to update, so that whenever our Spring Boot application gets started, our tables will be automatically created based on our entities. And the last two properties here is used to print the Hibernate SQL queries on the console. Now let's create the entity class on which we will enable Hibernate second level cache. So we will create this entity class inside the package entity. And the name of our entity class is city. Now let's mark this class as entity. Now to enable Hibernate second level cache on this entity, we have to use the annotation cache. And we have to use the org.hibernate.annotationcache for this. And here we will specify the cache concurrency strategy that we are going to use. So we are going to use strategy read-write. Now let's define our entity attributes here. First column name will be a ID, which will be the primary key. The next column would be the name of the city. And the name will be of type string. And let's have another column. Let's say we can have population. So all the entities columns have been defined. Now let's create the getters and setters for this entity class. So our entity city class has been set up. It has three attributes: ID, which is also the primary key, and we actually forgot to set generation strategy for this. So let's do it right now. And the other two columns are name and population. Now let's create the repository class, and for that we will create a package repository. And the name of the repository will be city repository. And this will extend this JPA repository. Now we will create a service class which will access this repository, and then later on when we create our REST controller class, REST controller will call the service class, and then service class will just delegate the calls to the repository class. We will create a package called service. Inside this, we will have city service. Now let's first auto add the repository. So we will do two operations on this repository. The one would be to get the city by ID, and the other would be to just save the city in the database. We will create a method which will simply return the city with a given city ID. And this method just simply calls the getOne method. And the other method is saveCity. Okay, so now let's create our REST controller. I will create a package REST, and inside this package we will create our city REST controller. And here we will just override our city service class. Okay, so now the first API we will create is to get the city by ID. And this will be a get API. And we will get the city ID by the path variable ID. And here we will just simply return the city. We will use the city service class to get the city ID. With the HTTP status of 200. So our get API is completed. Now let's go ahead and create the post API. And here also we will just delegate the call to our service class to save the city. With the HTTP status of created. Now let's run this APIs and check whether our Hibernate check-in level case is working or not. So let's start the Spring Boot application. Okay, so our application has been started on port 8080. And to test this APIs, I will use the Postman client. Now let's open the Postman here. So we will first test the save city method, that is a post API. So let's do that. http://localhost:8080/cities. We have to provide the JSON body. So the name of the city we will have here, let's say York, and the second property is population relation, and let's take any arbitrary number here. Okay, So now let's test this out. We'll hit the send button here. Okay, so the city with the name New York has been created. Okay, now we will try to fetch this city with the ID of 1. And for the first hit of the API, it will fetch the city from the database, and then the subsequent call will be fetched from the cache. So let's first hit the get API. http://localhost/8080/city/1, because the city that we have said has an ID of 1. And before we run this API, let's clear the logs of the console first, that we can observe the logs more clearly. And now let's run the API. Oh, so there is an error here. Internal server error, could not write JSON. So let's find out what the problem is. Oh, so the gate one matter of a JPA is being deprecated. So we have to use find by ID here. Let's run this again. The application is started. Let me clear the logs, go back to the postman, and here we have to save the city again because we have restarted the application as we are using H2 database. So the previous records will be erased. So let's save the city again, and now let's try to fetch this city with ID of 1. Here again I will run this API, and for now you can see that we have successfully fetched the city with ID of 1. And for this, you can observe that this city for the first time has been extracted from the database. So there is you can see that there is a query has been fired to fetch the city with an ID of 1. Okay, so now let's clear the logs here. So now if I hit this API again, there will be no hibernate query will be printed on the console here because it will be fetched from cache. So let's see if I hit this again and go back to here, and as you can see this time we have no database query being executed. So that means that our Hibernate second level cache is working. And let's verify again from a different client. Let's hit this API from the browser again, and if we hit this again we get the city. And if you go back to the logs here, you can see there is no log, there is no database query being here on the console. So that's confirmed that the data is now being fetched from the cache and not from the database. So that's it for the video. I hope you liked the video. If you liked the video, please hit the like and subscribe button. Thanks for watching the video.